I mean, I've always been a huge fan of Charles Dickens. He's a sort of an inspiration to me in his writing. His, you know, his right from an early age, from the age of 13, 14, I fell in love with like Great Expectations and David Copperfield. And his, you know, he wants to entertain, he wants to be popular, but he wants to tackle the big stage, you know, big themes like poverty and government and all that. But he also retains that sort of humanity. He wants to see how the individual is caught up. So there was that. This film in particular, I wanted to make, when I reread David Copperfield about 10 or so years ago, and it just felt so cinematic and yet funny and experimental. It felt very modern. You know, the opening chapter is David just being born, and just it's all written in words of like one syllable as he tries to make sense of shapes and colors and sounds and language, and then it gets more complicated. And then it's about this person growing up with, let's face it, status anxiety, just wondering if he fits in and his background and is he making the right friends? So that it all felt very, very modern. And also it's really funny. There's scenes in the book that I've never seen in any adaptation of. You know, when he falls in love with Dora, he sees the word Dora everywhere he goes. Or when he's drunk, it's described like, you know, he shouts, "I've got mad hair and I've got drunken hair." Dickens describes all of London sort of swirling around. It's like that scene in The Wolf of Wall Street where they're on drugs. So I felt cinematic. I want to kind of express this. This is the film I want to make because it also speaks on these sort of contemporary issues as well. And I just want to get that life and that humour and approach it maybe as if there were no rules as to how you made like a costume drama, because I wanted it to feel... The audience feel that the people they're watching up there are in their present day. This is their modern world. I wanted to do that.